such a monumental event for the city, the sponsors, everybody that puts it together, because we all will never forget. When you're tired today, when you can't take one more step, you guys need to look down, look at that lanyard, look at that picture, and remember why it is that we're climbing. It's not a race. We just want to try and finish so that we remember and we honor those heroes on 9/11. Our formal assemblies begin today with the introduction of the Edinburgh Fire Department Honor Guard and the Corpus Christi Pipes and Drums and our FAR Fire Department Pipes and Drums.
Honor Guard, present arms. Order, arms.
The chaplain of the Rio Grande Valley Firefighters and Fire Marshals Association, Gary Wilburn, will now join us for the invocation.
If you all bow your heads. O God, our hope and refuge, in our distress we come quickly to you. Shock and horror that tragic day have subsided, replaced now with an emptiness. a longing for an innocence lost. We came remembering those who lost their lives in New York, Washington, and Pennsylvania. We're mindful of the sacrifice of public servants who demonstrated the greatest love of all by laying down their lives for friends. We commit their souls to your eternal care and celebrate their gifts to a fallen humanity. We come remembering, and we now come in hope, not in ourselves, but in you. As foundations we once thought secure have been shaken, we are reminded of the illusion of security. In commemorating this tragedy, we give thanks to you for your presence in our time of need, and we seek to worship you in spirit and in truth, our God and our guardian. Never forget. Amen.
Honor guard. Parade. Rest.
And now, if you would, help me introduce guest speaker, Hidalgo County EMS Director, Kenny Ponce.
Ladies and gentlemen, elected officials and public servants, welcome to today's event. Today, I've been given the honor to address the Assembly of Honored Guests and Participants. My name is Kenny Ponce. I was raised in Edinburgh, Texas, and I've been a paramedic for 25 years. Today we are gathered here to honor those 9/11 responders who sacrificed their lives to save others on September 11, 2001 and afterwards from illnesses related to the attack. Today also marks the 17th anniversary of that tragic terrorist attack on the East Coast of the United States of America. On that beautiful, bright and sunny day of September 11th, our country came under siege by extremist Muslim terrorists. They had planned to deliver a surprise attack on the United States. The terrorist reason was to weaken our cause for freedom in the Middle East. However, the Muslims terrorists did not take into consideration the resolve of a great country. The attack instead unified the people of this nation in spirit, diverse religious beliefs, personal freedoms, love of the American flag, respect of different cultures, and most of all, the passion of liberty for all. The attack itself was a cowardly act of suicide and the murder of thousands of innocent men, women, and children. I quote from a statement made by the wife of the pilot of Flight 93. If we never learn anything else from this tragedy, we have learned that life is too short and there is no time for hate. The terrorists had underestimated the might of the American people. Instead, they had stirred a hornet's nest. They brought the country closer together in the old fighting American spirit. That day, our country became one nation under God, one nation under one flag, one nation under one common cause of American ideas of freedom for all. We saw on live TV acts of service above and beyond, acts of kindness, acts of bravery, acts of honor, acts of love, and acts of unity. Even the smallest act of service of kindness was seen as a way all Americans honor their suffering and dead. A way to reclaim the American spirit which first united us, the birth of this nation. As for myself, I love this great nation and I thank God every day for it. Thank you.
Thank you, Kenny, that was amazing. And now we want to recognize the couple. There's a better half, the duo. This is a huge undertaking to put together. It starts tomorrow. One day after we do it, we have to start planning for next year and make sure that we have 343 amazing people that are willing to take this climb with us. And it's such a huge ceremony to honor those people in 9/11. There's a couple that puts it all together, and they work all year long to do that, and that's Mark and Mindy Samora, so help me introduce Mark, please.
Good morning, and thank you for climbing. My better half is actually working her butt off right now, and I have to come up here and speak to you. But can you do me a favor real quick and look at the tags that you're wearing on your lanyards? The faces on those lanyards are the family-approved photos that the family of the firefighter that you're carrying has chosen for you to climb in. So we're really grateful for that. And that's something new this year, all right? So I wanna mention some things about the climb. When you're carrying the tag, what that tag resembles is what we have in the fire service called pass tags. They're personal accountability system tags. All right, whenever we get to a fire scene, we give one tag to the incident commander and we take one tag with us. If you think about it, it's kind of like the dog tags in the military. Then it identifies who you are and it allows people to keep track of who's out on the fire ground. So that's what that symbolizes. When you're done climbing, you're actually gonna come out and return one tag to our blackboard and right after you're done climbing. And you also ring a bell, which symbolizes you have carried the duties of that firefighter that lost their life that day, all right? We also, after you're done, you will have a photographer take a picture of the memorial prop. And I wanna remind everyone, just have a safe climb, have a great time doing this, and just remember who you're climbing for, okay? Thank you guys for coming out. We really do appreciate it. All right, thank you.
Thank you, Mark. The following sequence pays tribute to the 343 firefighters who perished on September 11th of 2001. The sequence includes a three-volley salute, the playing of taps, the ringing of the bell, and the playing of Amazing Grace. I ask that you reflect on that tragic day, 9/11, and the countless lives that were lost.
Honor Guard, ten, hut, present, arms. Honor Guard. Order, arms. Great rest.
Stay there.
I got it.
Now.
Okay, we're gonna do a couple series ones. Stay cheese for those, and then we'll do one.